Good morning, children. Hope you have understood the lesson metals and non-metals, which we have seen so far, and we have seen about the physical properties of metals and non-metals, and you have a clear idea about what are metals and what are non-metals so far. And now in this class we are going to see about the chemical properties of metals and non-metals and the extractions of metals if we can. Okay, so now we are going to see about the reactions of metal with oxygen. Almost all the metals reacts with oxygen, okay, but in different ways. Okay, some metals will react with oxygen spontaneously, immediately. Some need to have some catalyst, then only it will react with oxygen. And some metals, it needs heating to react with oxygen. And some metals need vigorous heating, so that only it will react with oxygen. So not all the metals react as such with oxygen. It has to undergo some steps to react with oxygen. Let me explain in detail about the reaction of metal with oxygen. Sodium and potassium are the most reactive metals with oxygen. Sodium reacts with oxygen in air at room temperature itself. And now let us see the equation here. Sodium, it reacts with oxygen. To form sodium oxide. Okay, here sodium reacts with oxygen to form sodium oxide. It is a spontaneous reaction, and this reaction takes place in room temperature. It need not have any heating or vigorous heating or catalyst. Okay, it's just like that. Sodium reacts with oxygen to form sodium oxide, and the balancing is given here. 4 sodium, 4 sodium and 2 oxygen, 2 oxygen are given here. And next one, most metal oxides are insoluble in water. As we have seen, sodium oxide and potassium oxide, whatever it is, all the oxides are insoluble in water. Let me explain that experiment with the help of an equation. See here, we have seen about sodium oxide here, and it dissolves in water. H2O is water, to form sodium hydroxide. What is this? Sodium hydroxide. And likewise potassium, this is K is potassium. Potassium oxide dissolves in water to form potassium hydroxide. Okay, so likewise sodium and potassium, not all the metals reacts with oxygen. Okay, so magnesium. Magnesium does not react with oxygen in room temperature, but it needs heating. Magnesium and oxygen together need some kind of heat energy to proceed the reaction. So magnesium, magnesium here, so it is reacted with oxygen in the presence of heat. Without this heat, the oxygen, without this heat, the magnesium will not react with the oxygen, and it forms magnesium oxide. Okay, it needs some amount of heat to proceed the equation. Next one is zinc. When we react zinc with oxygen, this reaction needs strong heating. This reaction needs strong heating. Even if it is strongly heated, the reaction will occur. So here, zinc, oxygen, it is heated very strongly to give zinc oxide. Okay, but sodium and potassium does not require that much of heat energy. But magnesium requires heat energy, and here zinc requires vigorous heating. And next one is iron. Iron does not burn. Even on strong heating, even if we put some iron filling through the burner, the iron will get heated and the iron will react with oxygen. Here, iron, oxygen, it is burned when it is put vigorously sprinkled on the flame of the burner. Then only it reacts with oxygen. So iron, presence of oxygen, needs heat to form iron oxide. The formula of iron is Fe, okay, ferrous. The chemical name of iron is ferrous, okay. So far we have seen about the reactions of oxygen with the metals, and it has some difference. Not all the metals react directly with oxygen, and each metal differs in its own way. Copper. Next we are going to see about copper. Copper is less reactive. It does not burn on heating. The hot metal is coated with a black color layer of copper oxide. It just while heating, the copper is coated with a black layer. Copper, heat, cuprous oxide. Okay, there are two types of valencies. If it is 2 copper, it is called as cuprous. The valency is 3, it is called as cupric. Okay, in later classes you will see about the valencies of the metals. Next one is aluminium. Aluminium also develops a thin oxide layer like copper. Copper develops a black layer. Likewise, aluminium also exposed to oxygen, it also forms a thin layer. So aluminium, when heated, it gives aluminium oxide. Okay, can you understand? So these are the reactions of metal with oxygen. So next one is anodizing. What is meant by anodizing? A coat makes it a further corrosion. The resistance can be improved by making the oxide layer thinner when exposed to resistant to air. Suppose we keep some iron block and it is exposed to air, okay, what will happen? The iron will be spoiled. That is called as a rusting of iron, okay. When it is exposed to oxygen, the moisture in the atmosphere makes the iron to form a layer of brown color layer. You have seen that is called as rusting of iron. If a coating is made above the iron, so if we paint the iron block, okay, we can save it from rusting, okay. That coating, that important coating, is called as anodizing. How will we anodize the metals is the next chapter. Anodizing is the process of forming a thick oxide layer of aluminium. Okay, this is the process. What is anodizing? Anodizing is the process of forming a thick oxide layer of aluminium. So this is technique. Aluminium article is used as an anode, okay. Electrolyte is used as dilute sulfuric acid. The anode reaction results in the formation of black colored thin film of aluminium oxide on the surface of the anode. Okay, so this is the particular, this is A, and this is a particular metal to be oxidized. Okay, this is aluminium. Okay, while passing this aluminium towards this metal, it will form a coat among the layer of the metal, and this will safeguard this metal from being spoiled. This is called as anodizing. Anodizing is the process of keeping the metal safe by aluminium layer around it. Okay, so this is the technique which involved in the process of anodizing. So this is the apparatus setup with the use of sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid is here, anode, acid, electrolyte. This is sulfuric acid. So this is the, when we pass electricity through this, okay, the aluminium layer will be converted to the metal layer. So far we have seen about anodizing, and let me give you some examples. By putting appropriate dyes on the electrolytic bath, colored surface with decorative finish can be achieved. Okay, so this is a cooker. Okay, so we have seen about copper bottom cooker, etc., etc., because these layers and inside some chemicals will be applied. These layers are being applied so that the metal will not be get spoiled. Okay, can you understand? kitchen articles like anodized pressure cookers, anodized pans, okay, and also frames of the sliding windows or the applications of anodizing techniques. The thing is, what is anodizing? Applying another metal on different metal to safeguard them from being spoiled is called as anodizing. So next one is amphoteric oxides. What are amphoteric oxides? Metal oxides are usually basic in nature. What is basic? Metal oxides are usually basic. They are not acidic. There are two types, acidic nature and basic nature. So in this case, metal oxides are usually basic in nature. Some metal oxides such as aluminium oxide and zinc oxide react both with acids as well as bases to produce salt and water. So this is some oxides like what is that, aluminium and zinc. It reacts with both the acids and bases to form salt and acid. See here, this aluminium acid, HCl. What is HCl? HCl is a base, acid. So this aluminium oxide reacts with HCl to form aluminium chloride. This aluminium reacts with this chlorine and this hydrogen reacts with this oxygen. Can you understand? This aluminium reacts with this chlorine to form aluminium chloride and this water, hydrogen plus oxygen gives water. Aluminium oxide plus sodium hydroxide. This is a acid here. This HCl is an acid and this NaOH is a base. So these aluminium oxide reacts with both acid and base. Here this aluminium reacts with sodium and water. H reacts with water. Aluminium reacts with sodium to form sodium aluminate and water is given out here. Okay, so hope you understand this equation. So reacts with acids and alkalis. Things, the oxides of metal which reacts with both metals and both acids and bases are called as amphoteric oxides. Okay, aluminium oxide reacts with both acid and base to form the product. So it is also called as an amphoteric oxide. So here the equation is given in words. Okay. Reaction of metal with water. Metals like potassium. See here, potassium, water, K. See, we can write this as HOH. Can you write this like here? Okay, so 2H will be here because 2OH. So this K reacts with this OH. Can you understand? This K reacts with this OH to form 2KOH. And balance, which is remaining, this 2H is remaining and 2H is put here, hydrogen. Hydrogen gas has been evolved, okay. K plus water gives KOH plus hydrogen. Metals on reaction with water gives out hydrogen, okay. Metal hydroxide and hydrogen gases evolved. See here, sodium. Same thing I am writing here. HOH, we can separate water as HOH, sodium reacts with water and this two hydrogen will be given out as hydrogen, okay, sodium hydroxide, this sodium hydroxide here and hydrogen gases evolved here, okay, hope you understand this very well, reaction of metal with water. See, the experiment is given here which we have read earlier, okay. Reaction of potassium with water, reaction of sodium with water. Sodium, we have already seen, sodium is a rubber type of metal and it explodes when it reacts with water. When we put a piece of sodium in water, it will explode. Here, potassium. So it also explodes sodium and potassium or different metals. As we have seen, they are not hard and it has a different kind of reaction with water. So next one we are going to see is calcium. See, calcium is a metal and it reacts with water. As we have seen earlier, we have to split it like this, then only it will be easy for us to do the experiment. Calcium hydroxide and water. Okay, this is a normal. Magnesium, same as calcium, magnesium also reacts with water to form magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen. Okay, so far we have seen about the chemical properties of metals, and in next class we will go with the chemical properties of non-metals. Okay, so if you have any doubt in this session, please don't hesitate to ask me. In the end of the session, I will be giving some assessment. Keep on doing this. Thank you.